Data Bank has announced that effective Thursday, December 2022, our offices will be shut down with staff allowed to work remotely due to the increased abuse and attacks. In a statement, the company said that it has been hit hard by the current macroeconomic challenges and the recently announced debt exchange program, making it difficult for the company to have access to the liquidity to meet the demands of the customers. Here is a statement from the bank. So we'll go through the slides now, and it says that many of our clients have tried to be patient with us as we wait for government to provide liquidity. For this, we are extremely grateful. However, there are several clients who have felt the need to abuse our staff physically and verbally, and also threaten their lives as well as their families. As such, we have no choice but to move to work from home option. Continues to say, while our offices will be physically closed, we will continue to serve you and process transactions remotely, and all our digital channels will remain open just as we did during COVID. However, we cannot engage and endanger the lives of our staff by opening the office without any available liquidity. We are fully aware that the current crisis in our industry is very concerning, and we continue to ask for your patience during these difficult times. We are very grateful, hopeful that the Financial Stability Fund on any other fund or any other fund that the government may provide in the interim will provide much needed relief for you and other investors. We will provide another update once we have a clear view of the situation. Thank you. These are excerpts coming from the statement of Data Bank that was released as a result of some of their staff being abused. Well, let's go on with the story. Meanwhile, my colleague Bright Amening has been pitched at the head office to bring us some updates or up to speed with the happenings in that particular office concerning Data Bank. So let's cross over to him. Bright, if you can hear me, good afternoon to you.
Fund management firm Data Bank has asked its workers to work remotely from home because, according to report, their staff being attacked by some persons, and so customers are here at the Adabaka branch here in Accra to find out what exactly is happening. Are they going to be able to get their funds? What were they told prior to the closure of these banks and the bank asking their staff to work from home? I am Bryce Nakusimene. I have here with me one customer who's already here and is worried, asking questions. Will he be able to get his money from the bank? Hello, sir. Good afternoon. Welcome to Metro TV. Now, you've been here since morning to find out even your balance, and you're unable to do that. What exactly is the problem? Were you told that the bank should be closed?
I don't know anything. I don't heard of anybody. So I'm just here to find out if I can get some money. But when I came here, nothing showed that they are working.
So you are telling me that you weren't told or given any information prior to the closure?
At all. At all.
So what do you intend to do now that you are unable to access your money?
I don't know what to do. As of now, I don't know what to do. I don't have any money in my pocket now. I don't know what to do. There's no information come to me.
What is your name and where are you coming from?
Felix Ekominsa.
And where are you coming from?
Kasua.
I come from Kasua. Do you need to get any Data Bank branch in Kasua? Why do you have to come all the way here?
Yes, I came here. I came to work. So I need money. As we are entering Christmas. So I'm here to get money.
And today is the 22nd of December, and as we speak, there's no money for these customers of Data Bank, and they are worried. They are here. They want to find out what exactly is happening. This man tells me that he was not given any information at all as to why the banks have been closed. He stays at Kasua, but he's come all the way here to Adabaka, you know, to find out whether he's going to get some money for the Christmas festivity. I have here with me another lady who also is going to speak to us and tell us what exactly it is for her. Us, the banks are not working, and they've been asked to go home and work remotely. Good morning. Patrick, your first name?
Your friend me, Auntie Maggie.
Auntie Maggie, what's your neighbor?
If you da kuma.
I don't know about it. That's not be. Are the bank be much be any da kuma?
I have na me yam investment, but ya ma kwanti. Me see me better say profit abaswa. Na me year no na me akwa to eduani akugufi. I feel me by a spirit in almost a Andra Menya message. I'm seeing your message, Bia. no se me hwe boy yi no so paper ne so na fe de ejinjira na atwe akasa akasa se ejinjira e se eden ya enya de ensa be kan isika den ya no mo se amanfo obetake wo eni nti na ma omo eja ye tifie ye ejuma no ofi nti o mbe start ejuma on the 3rd January no on the 10th no ma start so omo ma isika kakra kakra
na nti o ba ache tem na ba ze
oh me do have 9:30
9:30. Can I kindly speak to you? You've also been here since morning, if I'm correct. And you came here to find out whether you'd be able to cash out some money. But then you are left behind the security post because you are not allowed to enter.
I'm even this. I came way back from Kumasi. I went to Kumasi last week. And they said that I need the money urgently to travel outside Ghana. I'm having 46,000 plus with them. So when I went to Kumasi, they said they are saying a whole lot of things. So... And I took their number, that then I have to come to their head office here in Accra. So when I came yesterday, it was yesterday evening that I had a message that, you can see my things.
Yes.
It was yesterday evening that I had a message that they're supposed to remove whatever. So I said, no, still I have to come.
Hello,
they've closed this thing. I'm to leave 27th. I've gotten my everything. Where should I get the money to travel outside the country?
And you weren't given any notice at all? I mean, you didn't get any message at all?
Yesterday night, that I had a message that they've closed the distance, so I can't access the money. Me, I've made the distance request about November 22nd. November 22nd. After this, I still haven't gotten my money.
Do you feel that, aside the excuse given by the bank that your workers have been attacked, do you think that there's something else aside that? That's why you have been asked to wait until June.
You know, I was saving at different banks. So when the thing, I told them not to they shouldn't renew it again. So I took it to even guess about November 15th. I was not aware that something was happening. I even sent 11,700 to them.
They gave you no notice.
I was not aware. So it was 22nd of that November that I got the information and went to them that I need all my money. They've sent me that 11,700. It is left with 46,000. 46,000 plus. I need to leave the country. How am I going?
And it all will be about 57,000 Ghana cedis.
My money was to be almost 58,000 plus. But I don't know. I check it on my phone. It has reduced to 46,000 plus. No complaint because it was investment. Maybe it can increase and it can reduce. You see? But for that one, they have deducted more than 8,000 from it. They are saying they will give me 800, 900 plus. It says, still, I need my money, so give my money to me after date.
So what do you intend to do now that you have a deadline to travel?
Do I know what to do? When I went to Ghana, they said I should go and Bola. I said, where do I get 50,000 plus? Will you give me that money? Will you borrow me that money?
And so she came all the way from Kumasi. She's actually traveling out of the country. As you can see here, things are here. Document, clothes, dress and all that in this poly bag and a red bag here that she's just supposed to travel with. But then she's stuck because she's been told that she cannot access her money because the staff of the bank have been asked to go home. And as you can see here on the wall, this is a notice that has been pasted here by the company telling customers that they are not working until a certain date. Let me try and get close to that and read for you to listen. So it says, Accra, December 21, 2022. Please know that effective tomorrow, December 2022, all Data Bank staff will be working from home until January 10, 2023. Now, why this decision? It says we are in the midst of a macroeconomic crisis, which is adversely affecting our industry. And therefore, Data Bank, due to the crisis, many fund managers had a difficulty selling their government of Ghana securities. This inability to sell meant fund managers could not get necessary cash to pay withdrawal request. In instance, where bonds were sold, it was often done at a discount because the market value of bonds had fallen significantly. Now, this situation worsened after the launch of the debt exchange program on December 5, 2022. Following the launch, activity on the secondary market has...
Bright Amening coming through live from the Adabraka branch of Data Bank, and customers stranded there. Maybe authorities may want to consider and find a solution to the problem as soon as possible. We'll bring you updates as we follow up with the Metro News team.